kind of sound into my life. You brought love every day. You brought a new kind of sound into my life. And I threw it away. The song that I sing.
Doing the best I can. That's the Strobes there. I'll come on to talk about them in a bit. But now then, Vinyl Monkey here again. Sorry it's been a while. A few distractions and things going on, you know, life and all that. I thought I'd better get back into it. Thanks to William, who sent us a "Are you alright, Mally?" Message, which was very kind of him, which reminded me that it's weeks since I did a video. Now I'm going to get back on it. I've got a few projects in mind. Today's just going to be a quick ramble. I picked up some records yesterday in Newcastle. I'm going to talk about them. We've got all the current affairs, of course. Thank God the election is out of the way now. And let's just hope for the best. Let's hope that Labour have got more up their sleeve than appeared in the manifesto, let's say. And I say that as a long-term Labour Party supporter and member, but it obviously can't be any worse, but we've got to hope for better than that. But anyway, that's enough on politics. Telly, that's been a distraction as well lately, is it? You know, whether it's the Euros or Glastonbury. What's worse, do you think? What is worse on television this year? England's performances at the Euros, dreadful, absolutely dreadful. It's hard to see them getting past Switzerland unless there's a radical turnaround in performance, which obviously they've got the capacity to do, they've got the players to do it, but I don't know. I mean, apart from that terrible dirge the poor lads have to sing at the beginning. Well, I wouldn't sing it if I was there, but obviously, but they seem to have to now with all the close-ups on their faces and everything. And I'm sure that singing that terrible crap sucks the bloody life out of them before the first whistle goes, but it can't help anyway. But anyway, that's by the by. Best of luck to them on, I like the lad, they're a good team, one of the best teams we've had in a long, long time. I like Southgate as a person, seems a good guy. So all the best on tomorrow, Saturday. But then the other thing on the telly, I've never been to Glastonbury. I mean, I wish I'd been able to go back in the day in the 70s and that, but I never had the opportunity to go, but so I tend to watch a bit of it on the telly these days. But this year, every time I put it on, dear me, what was it, SZA or something, and I didn't know whether it was a musical act or what. I didn't know what it was. Made no sense to me whatsoever. Dua Lipa, what's that about? I mean, I thought I was watching The X Factor or something like that. I mean, it's just dire. And then to top it off, bloody Coldplay. Dear me. And I think I realised, I don't think I've ever heard anybody on the Vinyl Community mention Coldplay. Well, surprise. You've all got better taste than that. But anyway, no good me whinging about that. That's over for another year. I think it has become... I've watched a few videos lately, which are very good. I wish I could remember the names of the people who put them on, about why modern music's a crap and going into the sort of technical reasons of it. And of course, there's still great music, there's still great young bands coming through. I go and see them regularly. But at the top of the tree, and it seems to have infected Glastonbury, is this sort of banal, I don't know, I call it X Factor type crap, really, which I suppose it's Taylor Swift personified. What is Taylor Swift about? Anyway, so, yeah, distractions. Anyway, I went up to Newcastle yesterday, I went in the second-hand shops, and I only went in the bargain bins. I paid no more than, I think I paid between £3 and £6 for all the records I picked up. I'll turn that off, I'm going to have a quick talk about them, and I'll tell you about the projects that are coming up, and I'll hopefully get back to doing a weekly video. So, I got half a dozen or so records yesterday. I say all between £3 and £6, so all bargains. The first one I got was John Mayall's The Turning Point. Now, I don't know why, but I have never ever owned a John Mayall album. I had mates who had all his early albums and I were right into him. And I don't know, I seen it as sort of a like a blues school, you know, he had all the, obviously the names who went through his band and everything, but I just never actually got into the guy. But anyway, I picked this one and I thought I ought to have one in my collection. So this was £3. I thought I can't go wrong here. And I certainly can't. I've only played the first three tracks. Absolutely superb. The Laws Must Change, Sawmill Gulch Road, and I'm Gonna Fight For You, JB. All written by John Mayall. Really, really nice songs. But it's a sort of it's a live album of all new material. This, the sound is superb, the band is superb. There's a flute right up front and a saxophone, which is different. But it's got a sort of mellow, mild, acoustic-y sort of feel. It's lovely, absolutely gorgeous stuff, and not a drummer in sight on it, which doesn't detract at all. But superb. So that's, I think, from 1969, I think that album is. Yeah, 1969, John Mayall, The Turning Point. Lovely stuff. The next one, I'd never heard of this band at all, but I thought that is worth £3 for the cover alone. The cover is so bad, it's great. It's one of those type of covers. This is The Stoneman's, or The Stoneman's. It's called In All Honesty. And they're an American sort of country and western, traditional country and western, bit of bluegrass type style, vocal sort of country band. There's five of them, they're all brothers and sisters, the Stonemans. They're five of the children of the late Ernest Pop Stoneman, who was seen as one of the sort of founding fathers of commercial country music, sold millions of records back in the 20s, I think, and he actually had 23 children, would you believe, Pop Stoneman, in between making all those songs and hits. Lived in abject poverty, lived in a shack during the Depression and after the Depression, worked as a carpenter on and off. But anyway, these are five of his 23 children who formed this particular group, and they had hits and albums and TV and film appearances during the 60s and into the 70s. This one's from 1970, it's called In All Honesty. I had very low expectations on it, but I was really pleasantly surprised. I don't think they actually write the songs. I mean, there's a couple of Townes Van Zandt song, I'll Be Here In The Morning, really nice. Who'll Stop The Rain, John Fogerty. It's just a great sound, lovely vocal harmonies, and a traditional country music, but played really, really nicely. So, I'm delighted with that. Another bargain, The Stoneman's, In All Honesty, 1970. The next one. I do remember these vaguely, the Ohio Players, but somebody was waxing lyrical about them on a YouTube channel the other day I was watching. So I spotted this one for a fiver, and this is Fire from 1974, and it's sort of funk soul. I've only played the first couple of songs on it, again, really nicely played. Haven't got into it yet. Sort of typical cheesy 1970s cover. The Ohio Players, fire. The next one, the legendary bassist Ron Carter, played with everybody in jazz from Miles Davis downwards, and released lots of solo albums as well. This is one of his sort of, I suppose, later ones from the mid 70s. This is 74 as well, I think. This is Anything Goes, and I haven't listened to this at all yet. I haven't got a chance to get round to it, so I will look forward to that. He's got a I don't recognize the names of the other musicians on there. He's got flute on here as well, percussion, trombone, guitar. Yeah, Ron Carter, the legendary bass player. Then the next one is what you were listening to there. This is The Strobes. I've talked a lot about The Strobes, and how I wrote them off at the time in the 70s. I thought I didn't like them. I thought they were just posh boys and doing twee stuff. But until I seen them live, and then I got to really appreciate them. And this is their album, Ghosts. Again, it was really cheap, because the cover's a bit knackered. So this was in the Amnesty International charity shop in Newcastle. Great shop, great bookshop, by the way, if anybody's visiting Newcastle, Amnesty International on Westgate Road. And they have a little section of records, which are always, there's always something interesting in there, and they're always dead reasonably priced. But again, this one was £3. Like I say, the cover needs gluing a bit, but I've listened to the first side of this, lovely. Lemon Pie, which I think might have been a single, I don't think it did anything, but the title track, Ghosts, Angel Wine, absolutely lovely. And then the one you were listening to at the beginning, Don't Try to Change Me, absolutely gorgeous. So, Strobes, Ghosts from 1975. And then lastly, the one I picked up, the one we'll go out to, I think, will we? Yeah. This is John Martin. This is Piece by Piece. This is from 1986. So this was, he'd just come back, I think, to the Island record label. There he is there. I think this got, this sort of period John Martin got knocked a little bit, but I quite like it. It's his sort of jazzy, sort of smoky, jazzy, fuzzy sort of period where he sort of mumbles, and his early albums were characterised by just his gorgeous vocals and guitar playing, but this period he doesn't tell, you don't hear his guitar playing, and it's a sort of light, jazzy sort of, scuzzy jazzy sort of feel with him really mumbling the lyrics. But I really like this. I think it's I like this period. I've listened to just a few of the tracks on here. Nice, very very nice. We'll go out with it and you can be the judge of that. That's John Martin, Piece by Piece. So half a dozen records for next and out. I picked up in Newcastle yesterday, so over the moon with that. And I'll just round up by saying what I'm onto. I've got a couple of projects, which actually, that's one of the reasons why I haven't been, apart from being distracted by politics, the Euros, canvassing, knocking on doors, delivering leaflets, all of that sort of nonsense. I've been wanting to do a lot of listening, because a friend of mine remarked that he had a load of albums up in his attic, and so anyway, I went round to his house and he fished them out, and what an interesting collection. And I just picked half a dozen of them. I'll just give you I'm going to give you a quick flavour of a couple of them, just to give you an example. The stuff which is really on the edge of sort of proggy, sort of prog rock, Canterbury scene, that sort of stuff. So, Hatfield and the North, the brilliant Henry Cow, Miller Coxhill, yeah, Steve Miller and Lol Coxhill, really, really interesting stuff. And there's another 9 or 10 in there of a similar ilk, some of which I'd heard of before, and none of which I'd heard before or hadn't heard since the 70s. And so I'm going to do a couple of videos on that, but I really need to give them a good listening to do those videos justice and have some opinion to share on them, really. So that's one project. Then the other project, I just had an idea, which was, I think I was listening to Desert Island Discs, and I've often thought I better be prepared for when I get the call, but it was a variation on mine. I just thought, if you were going to get sent to a desert island with a decent hi-fi system and you could only have the albums by one artist, which artist would you take? And I've been thinking about that. Who you can take their entire catalogue, who would it be? And obviously there are some obvious ones that people might go for, people with very, very large catalogues. But I'll give it some thought, and I'm not going to spoil, I'm going to keep it in suspense, and I'm going to share who that is and maybe do a bit of a sort of ranking and run through their records as well. So that's what I'm going to do. We're going to go out on this video with a song from John Martin's Piece by Piece. This is Angeli.
Did I hear it saying the love and the heat of the name? Oh, Angeli, did I hear it saying cry?
Enjoy the footy this weekend. See you soon. Ta-da.